cells. Next one is nonlinear scattering. Nonlinear scattering in optical fiber is due to transfer of optical power from one mode to another mode or same mode with different frequency. So this scattering takes place in both forward and backward direction. It produces optical gain, but there will be a shifting optical frequency. The shifting frequency results loss of signal. And creates attenuation. So there are two types of nonlinear scattering. One is stimulated Brillouin scattering. Another one is stimulated Raman scattering. So stimulated Brillouin scattering. Now we will see stimulated Brillouin scattering. SBS occurs when the laser of light beam is traveling in optical fiber cable. There will be variations in the electric field of the beam. So these variations in electric field produces acoustic vibrations. This means incident photon of acoustic frequency. As well as it produces scattered photon. So the scattering is usually in opposite direction. To the top of the incoming beam, and is called as stimulated Brillouin scattering. So the stimulated Brillouin scattering usually occurs in opposite direction to that of the incoming or incident beam. This frequency shift is maximum in backward direction. The scattered light looks like upper and lower sidebands, which are separated from incident light by the modulation frequency. So the scattered light looks like upper and lower sidebands, During the scattering, a frequency shift is produced, which varies with the scattered angle. The threshold power of SBS is given by PSBS. Threshold power of stimulated Brillouin scattering is equal to 4.4 into 10 power minus 3 d square lambda square alpha dB and mu. Here the d is the diameter of the core. So lambda is the operating wavelength and alpha dB is the attenuation 8 dB per kilometer. Mu is the laser source bandwidth. The above expression allows the determination of threshold optical power, which must be launched into a single mode optical fiber before SBS occurs. So next one is the stimulated Raman scattering. So stimulated Raman scattering basically represents inelastic scattering of photons. Inelastic scattering of photons. So when the laser light is traveling through the optical fiber cable, the spontaneous scattering takes place. The spontaneous scattering takes place. In this process, some of the photons are transferred to the near frequencies. Some of the photons are transferred to the near frequencies. Let us, when the scattered photons lost their energy, when the scattered photons lost their energy, this is called Stokes shift. This is called Stokes shift. When the scattered photons gain energy, then it is called anti-Stokes shift. What is Raman scattering? Raman scattering basically represents inelastic scattering of photons. Inelastic scattering of photons. When the laser light is traveling through the optical fiber cable, spontaneous scattering takes place. In this process, some of the photons are transferred to the neighbor frequencies. Some of the photons are transferred to the neighbor frequencies. When the scattered photons lost their energy, this is called Stokes shift. Stokes shift. The scattered photons gain energy. When the scattered photons gain energy, then it is called anti-Stokes shift. Anti-Stokes shift. If the photons of other frequencies are already present, then the scattering of such photons takes place, and in this case, the two photons are generated. In this case, the two photons are generated. It is called as stimulated Raman scattering. This is similar to stimulated Bullock scattering. Instead of acoustic photon, a high optical photon is created. So SRS can occur in both forward and backward directions. So the threshold optical power for SRS in a long single mode fiber is 5.9 into 10 power minus 2 d square lambda alpha dB. Here the d square d is nothing but diameter of the core, and lambda is the optical wavelength, and alpha dB is the attenuation in dB per kilometer. The threshold optical power for SRS stimulated Raman scattering can be determined with the help of PSRS is equal to 5.9 into 10 power minus 2 d square lambda alpha dB in watts. And if you want to calculate power in milliwatts, PSRS is equal to 59 d square lambda alpha dB. Where d is the core diameter of the optical fiber cable, and lambda is the optical wavelength, and alpha dB is the attenuation in dB per kilometer.